Hi everybody, and welcome to another episode of Unboxed, Watched, and Reviewed. Today's movie came recommended to me about a year ago, but I didn't get around to watching it until recently. So, what's the movie? Well, let's take a look way back and find out. Here we go. Let's open it on up. Gross out. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, Willy Wonka 2. I mean, Gross Out. Midnight movie Gross Out, just plain disgusting. A John Waters style film. The synopsis on the back tells us that this is one of the grossest, most tasteless movies ever made. So yippee! So with that said, you guys ready to watch Gross Out? I know I finally am. Play. So Willy Wonka 2 begins with this nurse who is warning the audience, saying what you're about to watch will be the most disgusting thing you will ever see. And in a flight attendant fashion, she proceeds with some precautionary instructions.
Please hold your vomit sack like so.
Vomit sack? It's like the bitch has a puke bucket, a puke bag.
Over the bag.
After this mink stole wannabe spits some fake puke into the bag, the credits begin. After the credits, we meet Woodruff, Adonis, and Wilma, three siblings who have been ordered to go to their mother's house. As soon as they get there, they're greeted by her butler who, oh no, it's like cannibal suburbia with a guy in blackface with white around the lips in a gold suit. They go to the backyard and meet up with their mother, who is a divine-like character wearing a tutu and a hat that says, "Fuck everybody." After talking about how revolting her children are, she pukes. And this is some really, really fake-looking puke. It was her looking to the side and somebody dumping out a can of fucking soup or something behind her head. This puke scene is faker than the puke we just saw 2 minutes ago. We find out that this woman has a whole bunch of inheritance money, but is only gonna give it to one of her children. In order to get the money, the kids have to...
You must all start videotaping the most disgusting, revolting, sick-ass things you can find. And if you can make me rich, then the money is yours.
And there's the whole plot for you. Three people going around videotaping gross shit. Fake gross shit, mind you. This guy just put a bucket under her skirt, and now she's shitting out all over the bucket. Which, of course, just looks like wet chocolate cake being spilled from behind her. Watching this woman take a big fake shit was so unamusing that I started rambling about the shirt I was wearing. I'm not wearing it to be ironic. I'm wearing it because I like it. My dad used to get me penthouses when I was in 7th grade. You know, he'd go into the quick shop and buy them and then he'd come out and give them to me, probably in an attempt to make me less flamboyant. Around that time, I started making out with girls. One girl in particular. And one night when my dad dropped me off at her house, he said, "You're not getting into anything pink yet, are you?" And I said, "Not yet. Can't wait till I do, though. What do I say? Hey, Dad, got into the pink." I love Penthouse. I found this by typing in slut t-shirt into Google. And...
That's what your sexual craving is.
Anyway, back to chocolate scat. The shit now looks like a basketball covered in chocolate. So she gives them 1 week to tape the filthiest shit they can, and they set out to do just that. Now I cut to a restaurant where the siblings are sitting around chatting. The first thing that they do is rig a toilet so that it'll explode on whoever uses it. Well, some poor asshole goes in there and sure enough, it explodes, and he comes out covered in what looks like melted Tootsie Rolls. He just threw the shit at an old man and it landed on a table. Now he's lifting it up with a spoon, Salo style, and eating the shit. Then it shows us some old guy picking his nose, and I must admit, this part was a little gross. He keeps pulling stuff out of his nose. It's disgusting. You know how... Don't you text me. Don't you be texting me. I'm being texted during this, and it's interrupting my bullshit, and you want to know what my text messages are? pictures of Penny Marshall, present day. Why I would want those, I don't know. I am trying to explain to you this movie.
He's doing it still.
Adonis, the older brother, shits into everybody's food and says, wait until they're full, that way they'll puke up all the shit.
You told them I shit in your shit. And they're all saying, bleh! Of course they're smiling. These actors suck. They're going, laughing at themselves.
Then this guy named Mr. Sicko shows up, who is a homeless idiot who looks like the guy who lives behind the dump. Quit texting me, bitch. What a weird thing to text somebody.
And he just took out this big dick that looks like the sex tool.
He takes this hammer to his dick like he's Bob Flanagan, and then
it cut to the next day where the three siblings are having breakfast at an outside restaurant.
And Adonis is calling out to the people who are walking past him, saying, hey, if you can make my brother sick, you will get $100. The first guy to attempt to make this asshole sick is a pimple-faced zit juicer.
They're obviously fake, thank God. But some guy's like popping the zits with his teeth.
Then this homeless bitch walks up and says,
how'd you like to suck the worms from my crotch, fucking Mr. Miller?
That would be alright.
Oh, how'd you like to smell my ass, you fucking faggot?
That's okay.
It's my ass.
Adonis stops a guy and makes him an offer he can't refuse.
They're gonna give this guy $100 to suck the toe of a homeless woman. He's licking this black foot with like blue toes. It's real weird looking. Looks like he's eating a rotten sandwich. And this guy's just licking it clean.
They then hold a contest where strangers discuss their filthiest fetishes.
I'm a turd teaser.
A what?
A turd teaser. And suck them until they're half inch peeking out, then they flip back in. I just enjoy teasing a good turd.
Whoever has the dirtiest one wins.
I like making cum balls when I make love. Take a little flour and you roll it up into a little ball. Yeah. Then you put it in your purse for later.
The turd teaser wins and she says to Adonis, let me suck your turd. And he says, okay.
Yuck, so she's gonna go suck his poop.
The next night they return to their mother's house with their tapes.
Shut the fuck up, let's see this shit.
The tape begins with a woman drinking fake pee, a guy in a box screaming about rim jobs, and lots of fake feces.
Now there's a guy shitting on a toilet, they're just showing his face, making stupid expressions.
If you're disgusted by brownie mix, get your puke bucket ready. Or your puke bag, I should say.
He just pulled the shit out of his ass and achoo! Ew, that's disgusting.
Then this lady gives the trio a pair of her shit-filled panties and they start passing them around as if it's a joint.
Now Adonis is smelling the shitty panties like he's huffing something because he's going
They get all shit-faced off of the panty joint, then we see some guy pulling milk duds out of a toilet. I mean, shit.
This movie is simply a shit joke prolonged for 90 minutes. Now there's a guy waiting to go to the bathroom. It cut directly to someone else having to go to the bathroom. God, and of course the same looking shit rolled out of his jean. Now some lady in high heels just walked by and slipped in the shit. And of course it landed in her mouth. She looked at the camera and went, she stood up in her skirt and there's shit pouring out. Fake chocolate shit.
Who else has seen enough chocolate?
Now it cut to a lady in a bathroom smoking a cigarette, sitting on a toilet. And she reached into her ass and pulled out some shit and it was sticky and she threw it on the ground. I mean, if you think toilet humor is funny for 90 minutes, you'll love this. Oh my God, and now it cut to some guy in shorts shitting out all over his hand. I mean, it's non-stop shitting. It's just so redundant. I'm not finding this very funny.
The mother doesn't throw up and Adonis says there's one more clip. He presses play and it shows the mom sleeping and her kids jacking off over her face.
And the blackface guy is going from dick to dick, taking their cum and putting it on a plate.
The cum did not look like cum. It looked like...
The cum looks like an omelet. And he just put it over her face. It looks like pizza dough. He's just covering her face with this dough.
So he puts this large piece of dough-like cum on her face, and she freaks out. This violation is enough to make the mother sick.
The mom's on the ground, holding her stomach, gagging. And now the mom's slowly spitting out what looks like a Twix. Or a score bar.
Then Mr. Sicko walks in and...
Oh, and now he's two girls, one fingering the stiff chocolate that's coming out of her mouth. And they're exchanging the shit, mouth to mouth.
It then cuts to the three siblings who go to the bank, only to have their check get denied.
So they can't cash the check.
This scene went on, and they were just showing stuff that was totally unnecessary.
They're not even being funny, they're just negotiating. This movie is 45 minutes too long.
The butler, Rochester, shoots the mother to death, which results in her being covered in cranberry sauce. It then shows us the three siblings living homeless on the streets. And then, it's over.
So that was Gross Out.
What a stupid fucking movie.
It had a really good beginning. I was hoping the whole thing would be that entertaining, but it wasn't. It just got too boring and just so fake.
So what do I give Willy Wonka 2 on a scale of 1 to 5? Well, I'd have to give it a 1.
Like I said, it was good in the beginning, but then it just got dumb.
However, it did have its share of some amusing, filthy dialogue that was pretty original. Otherwise, this movie is nothing more than candy bar shit.
Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time.